Picture.
Hi guys and welcome back to my channel. Today we will have a very adventurous video, at least that's what's in my plans, because I finally feel inspired to do another fairy garden. And if you've been on my channel for a while, you know that I have a bunch of them, and you know it's a very interesting experience and very interesting task to do. So I invite you to join me and maybe feel inspired to do one of your own. But before doing one, I need so many things. So first off, I need a shallow pot because I want to work with desert looking houseplants like cacti, succulents and stuff like that, right? So I need a shallow pot. I also might need some kind of pebbles. I might look for some cool decorations, you know, that will give a little spice to this houseplant arrangement. And also I might look for extra plants because I already have some that I have on my mind, you know, to use. But also, who knows, maybe I'll find even more cool plants that, you know, can make this whole thing together and it will look gorgeous and amazing and fabulous. So today we'll go and look for all of those things. But before going into this, you know, adventurous beginning, we need to do something. I want to leave over here a message from yesterday, Svetlana, when I received a couple very interesting envelopes from one of you guys. And I was so confused and I have so many questions. So please show up in the comment section down below if you were the one who sent me those envelopes. But long story short, just go and see it yourself. Okay, guys, be honest. Who did this? I'm confused. I am so confused because just today I received something pretty weird in my mailbox, in my PO box. And it's from Canada and I haven't ordered anything from Canada. Why somebody decided to send me boxers and thongs? Guys, like, what the heck? Who did this? Is it a joke or maybe it's something really awesome? I'm not sure. This is a houseplant channel. I mean, kind of. Most of the time I talk in here about houseplants, right? And when I received my, you know, fans boxes, I am gladly opening them, you know, and dedicated the whole videos for these, you know, kind of events. But this? Who did this? It's not April 1st, and actually I'm pretty curious because it says guaranteed freshness for more than 2 days. Worn for at least 48 hours. Which is, I mean, it's cool. If you ask me, it's cool. I love the envelopes. Here is the proof that it's from Canada. But guys, what in the world? Okay, let's open one up. I'm so sorry. You know what? I recently looked at my, you know, channel's information and no kids are watching my channel. Most of you are adults, so let's see some boxers. I mean, it's just boxers, okay? Or is it not? Okay, well, that's definitely a piece of boxers. What the heck is going on?
That's a piece of boxers. And then... Okay. Sorry to disappoint you. No dirty boxers in here, but whoever delivered this to you now thinks you're weird. Oops, haha. Okay, this really got me. Oh my gosh, this is hilarious. I'm definitely gonna keep that somehow displayed somewhere because this is just... Who did this? Oh my gosh, let me know because... Nobody, you know, wrote me that, oh my gosh, I am sending something to you from Canada, be prepared, you know, check your P.O. box more often or something. Nope. Okay, so let's open that one. And guys, look how clever it is. Oh my gosh. It looks tongs, right? Oh my god. Okay, tongs. Look at that. It looks like a tongs, right? But I bet there's no tongs inside. Oh, you guys. This is clever. Oh my gosh, who did this? And yet to see the face on my boyfriend's face. You need to see the face of my boyfriend, of my fiance. So
somebody sent us underwears.
Okay, once again, no tongs inside, just, you know, a little piece of it, of the lingerie, and another note. Oh my gosh, this is... You got me. Oh my gosh. Okay, I'm not gonna lie. I actually was thinking maybe to open it without camera, you know, because it's underwear, you know, but... Nope. Oh my gosh. Okay, you made my day. Cannot wait to show it to my mom and my boyfriend. Just a prank, bro. And the same message, sorry to disappoint you, no dirty tongs in here, but whoever delivered this to you now thinks you're weird. Whoops, haha. Okay, this is hilarious. Oh my gosh, you got me. Wow. Wow, I haven't been laughing so hard in a really long time. Thank you so much, whoever did this. But let me know who did this. Leave a comment, please. I want to say a huge thank you because this was awesome. Actually, this package was opened by maybe a post people or custom people because there was, you know, this duct tape on top and the underwear are ripped. Probably wanted to see what kind of, you know, not smelly underwears were inside. Wow, this is hilarious. Oh my gosh, thank you so much whoever did this. Wow, okay, I really have no words. I'm definitely putting this somewhere near my face, you know, just to bring the smile to my face whenever I see it. Wow, this was awesome. Okay, and right now let's get back to today's video.
What do you think about this secret messages, secret envelopes I received? You know that you pranked not only me, but also my fiance, because, you know, the P.O. box is on his name. So he was the one who went to the postal office to take these envelopes. And when he saw those shiny envelopes with some underwear, you know, sticking out of them, he was so confused. And he says the postal lady looked at him pretty weirdly. So whoever sent it, it was really good prank. It made me laugh so hard. I shared the story with my mom and sister. It was so cool. It was so funny. And thank you so much for putting a smile on all of our faces. It was hilarious. Hands down. And it was awesome. Okay, guys. Let's say a big thank you, Rocket. Yes. Jennifer, thank you so much for tipping me via PayPal. It was such a cool surprise and, you know, you have a really big heart just, you know, to randomly send some money to us and, you know, help us out with Rocky's bills from the vet. So thank you so much. This was so unexpected because every single time it's so unexpected. And guys, sorry for the Rocky's walking sounds. Come say, babe. Come say thank you, baby. Come. Come. Say thank you, baby. He's so cute, isn't he? All right, so thank you once again, Jennifer. This was so, so sweet of you, and I cannot wait to, you know, have a positive updates for all of you, you know, with Rocky's health. But anywho, enough speaking, let's do some business. So buckle up, grab snacks, drinks, you know, maybe a coat, because it's really foggy outside. Have you seen this huge fog? I mean, it's still here and it's already 10:30 a.m. you know, so most of the time the fog is only in the mornings. But guys, look at it, look at it, so foggy, right? Ooh, sorry, so foggy. This is, oh, sorry. Oh, and what do you think about my sweater? I thrifted it for €2. Oh, what a find. Anywho, okay guys, let's go and have some fun and hopefully buy everything we need. So join me. Okay guys, so I just left the antiquing play spot and I did not came empty-handed, so I was so excited. Okay, a lot is going on. So alright guys, take two. Take number three. Alright, so I was in antiquing place and I found a bunch of awesome things, and one of those will be perfect for the fairy garden. Check it out guys. Isn't that a cute tiny cottage with a little light over here? You know, it's a simple pebble, but it looks so cute. This is a really cute piece and it was €4, but it was with 30% discount on everything. I think this will be perfect for a fairy garden, even though I have a desert, you know, inspired theme. Who knows, maybe I will use it in today's fairy garden and maybe I won't. I'm not sure, but it will be very handy. Also, talking about houseplants, I got this cute tiny pot with a drainage hole, which is amazing. It's handmade. It was €5, but once again, 30% discount. Look at this, guys. So beautiful, isn't it? I love all of the details. And you know what? This exact pot actually reminds me of Dea from Cozy Planting. Huh? Beautiful, right? Perfect for little tiny cacti I have. Oh, gorgeous. Last thing I got was a couple frames, and guys, look at these. Look at the details. It's so gothic and I love that they are two. So, you know, in one I can put my picture, in another one it could be Rocky or it could be my fiance. So I think this is a very interesting discovery and it definitely will be useful. Each of them was for €2 minus 30% discount, which is a great deal in my opinion. So really beautiful, right? Really, really beautiful, even though it's not for fairy garden, but still very, very awesome discovery. So let's get back to the fairy garden business. Right now we are standing next to the houseplant store, so that's where I will look for some plants and for a pot. So let's go, because my boyfriend with Rocky are waiting outside so I can film, you know, and then they can come back to the car because it's pretty chilly today. Okay, anywho, let's go to the plant store. So right now I'm actually also looking not only for a pot but maybe a decoration that could go into the fairy garden. Oh my gosh, this is really cute. I mean, I could definitely put this one in a fairy garden and make it Christmas inspired, right? But at the same time I want to work on cactus, and cactus with Christmas aren't really good match in my opinion. What do you think? There are so many cool ones. Oh my gosh, look at this. Sweet. This one actually is so cool. What an interesting vibe.
Okay.
Okay, I think I found a pretty perfect match. Let's look at this long one. With a drainage hole, so much space for playing. And it's only 10.99. Oh my gosh. Okay, I think we will be good. Alright guys, so I think I will be buying that white pot. So right now I'll go see some plants and we'll be back. But this white color is like perfect for Christmas inspired fairy garden. So right now I'm doubting the whole cactus idea, and maybe let's go see what plants they have. Hi guys, and welcome back to my kitchen. Everything went so fast. I actually changed my mind 3 times in this houseplant store because there wasn't too many beautiful and healthy, let's just say healthy houseplants, because I saw mealybugs, I saw spider mites, so it was really risky to go ahead and buy plants from the store, you know, and take them back home. But I think I did a pretty good job, so let me show you what I've got. Let's have the whole hole, you know? Okay, so first off, let's not forget this cute houseplant. This cute cottage. Right now my camera is focusing finally, right? Look at all those details. So you know what? I thought this will be a house of a Santa Claus. Yes, I went crazy and bought a random houseplants to play around and make a Christmas-inspired fairy garden. So let me show you everything. This is actually a statue I had in my home from some fairy garden. So I think I might use this one as well. And I came back home with a bunch of stuff. So let's start from this caprices. I mean, this tiny Christmas looking tree, isn't this cute? I think it will work as a perfect, you know, Christmas inspired tree. So it will be like Christmas tree slash it will be growing outside. So it's like, you know, just a simple tree that you'll find, you know, in the North Pole maybe, right? It was $3.99, which is I think a pretty good deal. So this is that, right? Then we have this random stuff. I actually have no idea what variety of plant that is. It looks actually like a moss combined with grass, so I'm not sure. But the label says that it's Selaginella, which was €3.69. And it looks just like a gorgeous bush, isn't it? So I think combined those two will really, you know, replicate the forest view or, you know, somebody's garden view, you know, during the Christmas, like for example Santa Claus is, right? So they will work perfectly. And also I've got this beautiful bromeliad, or this label actually says Cryptanthus, for $2.99, right? And it's just gorgeous. And I loved the shape. I loved the colors. When I'm planning to plant it, you know, a little bit on each side, so it will look just cute, cute. Cute, you know, plant that is like, you know, waving through the pot. So that, right? Also, I got this Christmas decoration that will stand in this garden and, you know, make even more obvious that it's a Christmas Christmas inspired fairy garden. And I just will put it somewhere else. It's like, you know, Elf Rudolph driving with some presents to the Santa, which is so cute in my opinion, right? And last but not least, I have this huge pot to play around. I love that it's not too shallow, so all of these plants should fit perfectly. And I also will use some plants from my older fairy gardens, you know, just because it wasn't too many options there. So
we will work with all of that, guys. But I think let's keep all of that to the next video, because it's already been a pretty long video. I'm not sure how many of you are left watching me right now. If you are, leave a snowflake emoji. If you are still watching, leave a snowflake emoji. I'll be so excited to see it. So anyway, this is where I will leave you for today's video, and just after stopping filming this one, I will film immediately the whole fairy garden, you know, putting together video. But before that, before leaving you, let me show you one of my fairy gardens that I made this summer, and you will see the whole update. So this fairy garden was planted about a half year ago. I called it Hobbit inspired fairy garden, and I combined so many different houseplants. In here you can see Zizi Zanzi, right? In front are two beautiful Sansevieria skirkii, aka Dracaenas. One is copper toe, another one is green version. We also have gorgeous Euphorbia over here, right? And gorgeous Christmas cactus that actually is blooming right now, which is so cool. I was not expecting, you know, to rebloom it for me, because in my whole houseplant career, never in my life I made these Christmas cacti, or, you know, Thanksgiving cacti, to bloom for me for the second time, but this one did. I cannot wait to see the inside of the blooms, because they have pink, beautiful inside. Anywho, so this is how it's doing. As you can tell, it's doing amazing. Actually, you can tell that this Euphorbia grew so much. When I planted it, it was still over here. This is also the spot where it was, you know, at that time. So as you can tell, it grew a very big amount of new growth, new branches, and in my opinion, it looks so cute. So all of these plants are thriving. Actually, if you look close enough, you can see that the house of the hobbits are a little bit on the side, right? So these plants, while growing, I think this Euphorbia specifically actually took the house with itself. Let's try to put it back. Oh no, you see? Oh my gosh! Actually, this Sansevieria kirkii is growing a baby. I'm not sure if you can tell. Over here, there is a baby, light green, right? So this baby was actually pushing this house up because it wanted to see sunlight. Oh my lord, I'm so sorry. Okay, but we are good. I moved the house so this Sansevieria can grow right now and be happy and do its thing. Oh my gosh. This fairy garden is thriving, guys. It's thriving, and I'm so excited and proud of it. Oh. So in the next video, you'll see another creation of mine with simple style and, you know, a lot of random houseplants. But for today, this will be it. So before leaving you, let me teach you another language lesson. I'm out of breath. This is a pretty heavy pot. Whew. Okay, so since we saw a baby of Sansevieria kirkii, let me teach you how to say a baby in Lithuanian and in Russian. Why not, right? So if you want to say baby in Lithuanian, you need to say kūdikis. Once again, kūdikis. And if you want to say baby in Russian, you need to say do these random brain farts happened to you as well? Because this is exactly what happened. But if you want to say baby in Russian, you could say novorozhdenny rybenok. This is what comes to my mind right now. Novorozhdenny rybenok, which is like newborn baby. Anyway, this was pretty difficult. Okay, guys, thank you so much for watching. I really enjoyed to have you together with myself. Let's chat in the comment section. How do you think I did with all of the combinations I got from, you know, different stores? Because I'm so excited to pull all of this huge project together into one spot and have something magical. So stay tuned, subscribe if you want to see how this fairy garden will turn out. Please comment, like this video if you enjoyed it. And I will see you in my next one.